Hi friends, today I am going to show you how to use this 300 watt XL4016E1 buck converter module. This little module is very powerful and can even be used as an alternative to a bench power supply. So let's get started. The word IN is printed on the input side of the connectors on both sides of the PCB. Similarly, on the output side, the word OUT is printed on both sides. Also, the polarity of the connectors is also mentioned as positive and negative signs. Both the positive connectors are kept on the outside and the negative connectors are in between. But keep in mind that the ground is not common between input and output, so keep the negative wires separate as well. I will now do a final checkup before connecting the module to the DC input by looking at the information printed on the PCB. Although we can give this module anywhere between 8 volts to 40 volts, but the output volts are always less than the input volts. Which means if I want to get a 12 volt regulated output from this module, then I will need to give it at least 15 to 16 volts to get a reliable 12 volt output. Now the left meter shows the input voltage and the right meter shows the output voltage. You can see that I am increasing the input volts, but the output volts remain the same. Now I will show you how to change the output voltage of XL4016 buck converter. You can see two small potentiometers on the top of this module. The potentiometer on the left hand is the one used to adjust output voltage. Turning it clockwise will increase the voltage, while turning it anti-clockwise will decrease the voltage. Right now I am turning it clockwise and you can see that the output voltage are increasing. XL4016 has the ability to limit the output current. You can adjust the output current using the potentiometer located on the top right of the module. Turning the potentiometer clockwise will increase the output current and turning it counterclockwise will decrease the output current. Now it is time to do some stress testing. I have set the output current to the max and now going to burn this steel spring. Let's see what this module can do. Wow, it managed to melt the spring, which is great. Let's try that again. The spring is glowing like a bulb and melted again and again. I think our module has passed this test. So let's proceed with the rest of the video. XL4016 is an extremely efficient module for its price. It is so efficient that it can be used as a solar MPPT for up to 40 volt solar panel arrays. I will now show you its efficiency by doing a practical check here. I have set the input voltage of my XL4016 module to 20 volts and now I am setting the output volts to 10 volt and the output current to 3 amps. Now 10 volts multiplied by 2.97 amps is equal to 29.7 watts, which is the output of our XL4016. If we multiply 20 volts with 1.76 amps, then we get 35.2 watts. So our XL4016 is getting 35.2 watts as input. Now if we divide 29.7 by 25.2, then we get 0.843, which means our XL4016 module is giving us an excellent efficiency of 84.3% at 20 volts. Now let's check the output quality of XL4016 module using an oscilloscope. I have noticed a constant ripple in its output which changes with the output current. I am now increasing the output current, and you can clearly see that the ripple is also increasing. The peak ripple is measured at around 100 millivolt on full load. It is not a concern while powering most of the devices, but it still can be an issue for radio transmitters and receivers. Now it is time to show you the exact dimensions of this module in case you want to 3D print casing for it. This module is 2.55 inches or 6.5 centimeters long and 1.9 inches or 4.8 centimeters wide. The height of this module is a little below 1 inch or 2.4 centimeters to be exact. Although this module looks a bit heavy due to the large heat sinks attached, but it still weighs only 67.2 grams. This reminds me an important thing to mention. Due to the presence of two similar heatsink plates, some people assume that there are two XL4016E1 ICs present on this 300 watt module, but this is not true. There is only one XL4016 IC in this module, and the heatsink attached to it generates way more heat than the other heatsink attached to the HBR2045, which is a Schottky diode. So if you are planning to add a fan for cooling purposes, then make sure to direct its airflow towards the heatsink mounted on XL4016E1. There is an LED indicator present on this XL4016 module, which indicates the power and load state of the module. In normal conditions, the LED will glow in the blue color, but if the module is overloaded and the current limit is being applied, then the LED will turn red. Now, I want to mention a concern I have about the maximum input voltage of this XL4016 module. As you can see, there is an LM78L05 voltage regulator present on this module, along with this LM358, which is an operational amplifier. We know that both of these are only suitable to work at 30 volts or below. So it seems to me that the components on this module will be overstressed if you try to reach its maximum input limit of 40 volts. If you like my video, then like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel. Take care of yourself. See you soon with another video.